Welcome to Spiritual Awakening Family. We often read about the necessity of balancing the energies in a twin flame connection. And now, with all the new high frequency energies streaming in, this balancing need gets even intensified and is more challenging than ever before. But how do you do that, and how does that really feel? And how can you tell that it is happening and you are making progress? First of all, and although I repeat myself, we have to keep in mind that all that happens in a twin flame connection happens for a reason and is perfectly guided by our soul. Twins present exactly the situations to each other they need to heal and grow, and it is our choice, based on free will, whether we accelerate or delay this process. The journey is so tough and challenging in the beginning, because we are supposed to break down completely and shed all traumas and societal programming from the past, so that we can rebuild ourselves to a much more resilient state. Seeing it from an energetic point of view, our system needs to rid itself from all lower frequencies, so that all chakras are open and in harmony, so that the higher frequencies of light and love can enter and stay. A system that is energetically not clean will not be able to handle those high frequencies for long. It would simply burn out. That is why it is happening gradually. The bubble love phase in the beginning shows us how these high frequencies feel. It is supposed to be the bait in front of us to keep us going and to remind us of what we are striving for. Being able to feel these high frequencies on a permanent level, so that we can shine this light onto others, inspiring them to do the same and to be brave enough to go for it. This is part of our mission, and that is what we are here for. We definitely did not come here to just fall in love with a partner and live happily ever after in La La Land. We definitely did not come here to just fall in love and live happily ever after in La La Land. The second thing we have to understand is that we are not him or her, me and you, this and that. No, we are parts of one soul incarnated in two bodies. So when we are blaming the other half, we are blaming ourselves. When we are angry at them, we are angry at ourselves. When we love them, we love ourselves. There is no separation. This is only a 3D illusion. The sooner we realize this, the sooner we recognize that all the healing work we do for our growth, we are actually doing for the two parts of the whole. A question that always comes up from twins is, why do I have to do all the work? Do you see now that this question is unnecessary? Because I does not exist in a twin flame connection. The other half is doing just as much work by acting the way that is needed so that the two parts can heal and become whole. Let's take a look at that again from an energetic point of view. When in a real twin flame connection, we are energetically connected eternally. When we do our work of dissolving and thus raising our frequency, the other part of the same has no chance but to adapt to the higher level as well. We inspire the other energetically, so to say. When that happens, the twin pair raises its energy to the same highest possible energetic frequency when in a physical body. This energetic match is necessary to be able to reunite. Before that, we are energetically blocked to come together. That is why we are experiencing so many obstacles and weird behaviors when trying to force a reunion. Energetically, it is simply not possible when we are not ready, and that creates disharmony and pain. An additional challenge adds the energetic disruptions of the collective pain and traumas. The collective pain of suppression of the female qualities, such as sexual creative power and vulnerability, are surfacing now big time. Men and women all over the world are struggling with that, and we, as empaths and transformers of energy to raise the frequency on Earth, are feeling that. We experience this, now that the first big ascension wave has started, much more intensely than ever before. And despite these disruptions, we need to manage our own balance to function properly and do what we came here to do. Despite the energetic disruptions of the collective, we need to manage our own balance to function properly and do what we came here to do. That brings us to the balancing of the male and female energies of twin pairs. It is often referred to as the dance of the twins, because during the balancing process, a push and pull dynamic is caused between the parts of the whole. It starts out very intensely and smoothens more and more in the course of the process. This happens in three steps. The borders between these phases are fluent, and we can experience parts of the next phase already, although still having some work to do in the preliminary phase. 1. The individual balancing of the two parts. This is the phase when we are asked to cleanse all the lower frequencies out of our systems that have blocked our chakras and energy system. It is the most excruciating experience, because we have to discover first what is actually happening to us and find a way how to deal with all the overwhelming energy releases that the twin flame encounter triggered in us. This is the time when all of our own fears and past trauma and patterns come to surface. We are experiencing incredible pain, and the healing process and release with crying or anger attacks can last for days, weeks, months, and even years, depending how much is piled up inside and how ready and open we are to face all of this. It feels like being on a permanent roller coaster ride from the highest highs to the lowest lows. We are swinging back and forth between our own masculine and feminine energies. This results in overthinking everything and spiraling thoughts when we are in the masculine energy too much, and emotional breakouts and overfeeling when we are in the female energy too much. We can feel completely blissful and happy in the one moment and absolutely devastated in the next, and this can change from one minute to the other and back again the next minute. The whole energy system is rebalancing the energy change that the encounter triggered, often referred to as Kundalini rising. It is systematically cleansing out low frequencies of every corner of your system. Nothing gets the chance to hide away any longer. We start to see 1111 everywhere, representing the portal into a new life with a new beginning. It is an invitation to leave the old and fake 3D self and life and move forward into the direction of our true life purpose. In this phase, we are very sensitive and vulnerable to everything, and we feel the need to be away from people often and are drawn to nature and water to rebalance. We long for peace and quietness. Everything we pick up with our senses is intensified. Noise, for example, can bother us much more than before. This is the most exhausting part of this journey, because our old self is dying. It is the time of making our ego surrender, and it is fighting hard to keep its position in the lead. This is why the fears and emotions are so intense. Our ego shoots every fear at us that it has available to make us go back to regular 3D behavior into our comfort zone. It is tough, and not everyone makes it through this phase, because it means to let go of everything we used to believe to be true. It asks major life changes from us, being completely true to ourselves and being 100% authentic. It requires to face our fears and go through them in order to dissolve them, and that hurts like hell. But it is all worth it. Once we made it through this first phase, the result is 100% self-respect and self-love. We are absolutely authentic and put our needs first. We don't do anything anymore just to please others. No one can push any button for us anymore, simply because there are no fears or traumas left in us that could trigger a reaction. 2. The balancing between the two twin partners. The second phase is all about balancing the energies between the parts of the split soul. Typically, the two parts are not split equally into half. One usually has more female, the other one more male energies within. This is also quite challenging, because in this phase, these energies are tuned into each other to get used to work together in a harmonic way. We see 11 very often in this phase, representing the two individuals coming together with the intention to merge. Often it is combined with seeing 77, meaning that the higher self of the two is working on the balancing. This is also typically the phase when we learn that what we are feeling is not necessarily only ours. We learn what is affecting our energy system, and when our system is overloaded, we learn how to rid ourselves of these energies or to avoid certain situations that might stress our system even more. We learn how food, medicals, solar activity, EMF, crowds, city density, earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, etc. can influence our sensitive system, and we learn to tell the difference between the energies moving through our system and where or from whom it originates when it is not ours. What we feel now feels different than what we experienced in the first phase. Now, we are hit by sudden emotional attacks out of nowhere, be it sadness, anger, worry or restlessness, but also bliss and love. They come as fast as they go. We realize that body activity, be it running, dancing, cycling or also masturbation, can help to release these energies immediately, often resulting in a good cry. In a second step, we learn how to redirect these energies and transform them into something useful, such as helping someone or putting them into some creative endeavor like writing, composing, painting, etc. We have days when we realize we are completely in our head, and then again days when we are completely emotional and vulnerable. The pendulum swings between the male and female energies of the twin pair. The more we accept, the more unfamiliar energies for our part, be it the masculine or feminine portion, the more we assist to open up the other half to be able to take in more of our main energy. So if you are the more female part and you realize you are much more in our head than you usually are, accept it, embrace it and tell yourself it will pass. It is just an effect of the balancing of the energies and will help the other half to take in more female energy. The same of course counts the other way around. When we made it through this part, we feel inner peace and bliss, and we have no doubts left about this divine connection. The result of that step is 100% freedom and independence. After that phase, it feels as if our partner is already here. The energetic component overpowers the physical, and we do not experience any longing or pain anymore. We are truly able to feel unconditional love for our other aspect, and we use this energy to move forward with our own mission and dreams, knowing that we are eternally connected and nothing can take that away from us. We are doing what we love for ourselves, not because we want to get to reunion as quickly as possible. We know that reunion will happen eventually, either on this plane or beyond, and that is all that counts. Time loses its meaning. We trust in our partner and in this process completely. As already mentioned, we can still have a bad day, experiencing body pains or emotional attacks from the collective pain or from disruptions in the geomagnetic field of the planet. Twins tend to project those pains onto their counterpart. Being aware of it when we are hit by such a sudden breakout helps immensely to not overreact and to ground ourselves quickly again. 3. The balancing between the twin pair and God. Source: only when a twin pair was able to balance the energies between the two bodies and energy systems, the gateway opens for the balancing with source energy. This is often referred to as the third energy, and this is quite an experience when this happens for the first time. This part of the balancing journey is a wonderful experience, because in the higher realms, lower frequencies of fear, anger or sorrow do not exist. We are now aligning with the high frequencies of the universal and unconditional love of Source, God, to be a powerful creator, role model and spiritual leader. We are seeing 111 a lot, showing us that the three energies are coming together and merge. 111 is a sign of energetic reunion, and thus also a physical reunion becomes more likely. This is often accompanied by 777, telling us that our spiritual guides support us and tell us that physical union is to happen, because there is a higher plan, although our free will might still work against it. And we can even see 7777 a lot, the ultimate sign that the spiritual realms are pulling all the strings now to overcome free will and collective pain in the way, which in that phase is often communicated through seeing a combination of 111 and 1111. All of a sudden, we experience a blissful state on a pretty permanent level, with only some physical and emotional symptoms or some restlessness when something major is happening on Earth, such as geomagnetic storms, earthquakes, or also when the collective human energy field reacts on something, as it happened for example with the terrorist attacks in Paris, or the general collective pain surfaces. Nevertheless, as we know our system so well by now and we know what it needs when our energetic tolerance border is reached, so we are able to rebalance very quickly and we recognize it as our radar system to sense if something bigger is going on. Our communication with the higher realms is stable and our higher self feels integrated into our bodies. The guidance is flowing naturally. We are experiencing the third energy, which is the sexual energy of creation, flowing in as something very powerful and sacred, coming from a place of love, not fear. We are experiencing the third energy, which is the sexual energy of creation, flowing in as something very powerful and sacred, coming from a place of love, not fear. These energies are truly divine and powerful in a very pure and innocent way. They open the gateway to the vast pool of consciousness that connects all of us, and our wisdom grows immensely on a daily basis. Sexual energies going through the heart and upper chakras feel completely different than one going through the lower chakras, when it is still related to fear and or attachment. When feeling sexual energies through the higher chakras, we don't feel the need to come to an orgasm. We just enjoy the moment and this permanent fulfilling and lovely vibe. We don't even need a physical touch to experience this. We completely love and accept our body and see its beauty. We are appreciating this miraculous gift of being able to feel unconditional love and the spiritual sexual energy in a physical form. Now, the energies within us, within our soul connection and with everything around us feel balanced and in harmony. We feel like we could just explode because of all the love we feel, and we just want to share it with everyone. We experience a feeling of oneness with everything, experiencing a permanent being in the flow. All we need just comes naturally to us as we operate on these high frequencies of love and creation. We have learned the art of manifestation. We have stopped trying and are just allowing things to happen, and our jaws drop again and again due to the wondrous miracles the universe gifts us with each and every day. Often, people just stop and look at us and are amazed by the light and love we are radiating, and we are more than happy to share these moments with them. We draw people towards us naturally when they need our support and want to hear what we have to say and feel what we can pass on to them to help them finding back to their power, too. The result of this state is 100% commitment to your mission and sharing our freedom and self-love not only with the other half of our soul but with the whole existence. When reaching this level, it is not important anymore to us to reunite on this plane, because we see behind the veil of the illusion of separation and we feel the unconditional love for each other so strongly, knowing that nothing can separate what belongs together. Now don't get that wrong. Of course, we would still love to share our love and happiness with the other half, but we do not need them anymore to be happy, enjoy life and feel loved, because we are whole by ourselves. Funny enough, when we don't need our twin anymore, the door opens for a possible reunion in the physical. Funny enough, when that happens, then the door opens for a possible reunion also in the physical. This whole process of balancing prepared us to teach and spread the new template of love, one without any insecurity based on total freedom and independence. So be love and share. I hope you like the video. Welcome to your channel. Don't forget to check out the other uploads.